Hello there. Welcome to yet another episode of Checkpoint on Urban TV. My name is Lynn Komjisha, and we get to speak 21st century skills. Yes, that means we are at the sidelines of the fourth annual Teacher Education Symposium. My apologies. It is the fourth annual Teacher Education Symposium. And we are sitting down with people who think that the 21st century skills are the most important skills any of us needs right now. So I'm going to have this conversation. We are going to have this conversation and get to understand, what are these skills? Who needs them? Why do we need them? At what point do you want to apply these skills? And where? Yes. So with me is Miss Mujisha Annette. She is the Assistant Commissioner, Teacher Education Training and Development. That is Ministry of Education. I also have the Director Programs at Luigi Giussani Institute of Education. That is Gillian Atheire, as well as the Country Director of the British Council here in Uganda, and that is Chilufya Besa. I have tried to pronounce that name. Ladies and gentlemen, a very warm how are you, and welcome to the show. Wonderful. I'm going to start with Ms. Mujisha Annette for reasons, because she has to run away. We are at a symposium, yes? So she's our host. So she has to do a few things here and there. We had to, you know, sit her down for a bit. We stole her from the symposium. So Mrs. Mujisha Annette, I don't know, is that a Mrs. or a Miss? Miss. Right. This symposium has grown over the years, yeah, because being the fourth, and we're wondering, what inspired it? What have we achieved from it? How is it going? Where do you see it going? What are you excited about it?
Thank you very much, our presenter and our host. My name is Mugisha Annette, as you have pronounced it, said it. I work as Assistant Commissioner, Teacher Education Training. That's my title. But I'm in the Department of Teacher Education Training and Development. Our department has two wings. It has the section or the division that focuses on the initial training, when as teacher trainee is still at the institution. Then the other division is focusing on the teacher who is already in the field. So that's why the department is called Teacher Education Training and Development. The training is mine, development is for my other colleague. So we are two assistant commissioners. Why did we start the symposium? Symposium, first of all, as a department, we search and asked ourselves, a teacher is one who makes everyone. If you want good lawyers, you want good doctors, you want whoever you want in a country who is good, must pass through the hands of the teacher. And therefore, we sat as a department and said we needed something that would bring us together, not only as a department, but with our development partners, our well-wishers like you, because if you broadcast what you are doing, you are somebody who is supporting us, so that we share what we are doing, we share the success, we share the challenges, and then at the end of it all, we say, what is it that we can do to make sure that we improve education? You know very well, there is no education that can be better than its teachers, the quality of the teachers. Now, if you want good quality of education, you must have good quality of teachers. So we, in this symposium, one of the main objective of meeting is to make sure that we share ideas from within the country and outside the country of how we can improve teacher education. Teacher education focusing on initial training and focusing on the teachers who are already in the field. We have to focus on both, because the ones who are still at the training, we equip them with what we think they should go out with. But even when you're already outside, there are other things that come in where you must know how to deal with them. For example, There are people who trained before anybody talked about a computer. Today yeah. we are saying everybody has to be computer literate.
Yeah.
So now if we ignore you in the field, that means you'll never know about the computer. But you are dealing with the learners who know about the computers.
Sure.
So how do you deal with them? You need to be equipped. That's why we cater for the ones who are still training and the ones in the field. Now we started in 2018. That was our first symposium. And there we are looking at generally how can we support a teacher to make sure that we have improved learning outcomes. Now, in 2019, we looked at two important documents that support a teacher. And these documents were a result of one study that was taken by UNESCO focusing on teacher initiative in sub-Saharan Africa. That study discovered that a lot of teachers were very demoralized. They didn't like their job. And many teachers were absent together with their learners.
Yes.
So, then at the end of it all, there was bad quality of teachers we produced, both in the field and those ones in the institution. And then it gave recommendation of how those issues could be addressed. One of them was that even if you were given everything that you are supposed to use as a teacher and you are not motivated, you will do nothing. And therefore, we needed to develop what we call teacher incentive framework. The framework that would address the demoralization issues so that a teacher is appreciated. And we also have a recommendation that comes from that study that was saying we needed to focus on the teachers nationally. And therefore, it recommended for development of national teacher policy. The national teacher policy would focus on producing a skilled and a competitive teacher. That teacher could be able to compete in the country or out of the country. That teacher that would be suiting for the labor force within the country and outside the country. So in 2019, we focused on making the public understand what the national teacher policy was talking about and then what the teacher incentive framework was requiring. You, the stakeholder, as a head teacher, as a parent, as a community, should do. Now in 2021 and 2020, first of all, we had a lot of confusion with the COVID. But we still now brought at table to share with people comprehensively what the national teacher policy was calling for. Now today, this symposium, we are looking at, yes, COVID came. We closed all the schools, the people were hiding, and thank God you and I and my colleagues here, we are still alive. We can't overlook it. So the symposium that we are having today, we are saying all this happened. What can we do to support the education sector to jumpstart it? When you have a vehicle and it fails to start, you look for another one to jumpstart it. You look for a way of jumpstarting it. Yes. So we are saying, how can we jumpstart it? And we are saying, what is the role of the teacher? So that's what we are focusing on. So to cut the story short, I want to say that the number of things that we have achieved, teachers are not as that level when we started. We have a number of teacher educators who present papers, who have results of what they have studied from one symposium month when we finish to another one. We have many people who have now understood what the teacher incentive framework demands for them as the head of institution, as the community around the school. We also have the national teacher policy being implemented at different levels. Now we have the task force, the National Council of Higher Education has already inspected all the institutions, and we are going to change the beginning of the starting of the teacher training.
Wonderful, wonderful. That's a very interesting, you have literally broken down why we are here. And it's very exciting to know all that. And well done. Over to you, Chilufya. I like the name. Over to you, Chilufya. We are talking the 21st century skills. And British Council, what is your interest in this, first of all? Secondly, what are these 21st century skills that everyone talks about? And what are they? Who do they target?
Thank you very much, Lynn. But those are two really good questions. So British Council, what is our interest? Well, the British Council, I would say, has been the longest development partner in Uganda. We've been here over the last 70 years, consistently supporting the Ministry of Education and Sport. So we've been a reliable partner, and that is why we are part of this journey. That is our interest in the 21st century skills, because we have been working so closely with the Ministry of Education. And when they asked us to bring in our expertise to help them roll out the revised lower secondary curriculum, we came in and we're working with the ministry to do this. So 21st century skills, what are they? I think that's a really good question, because that's a question that's being asked a lot all around Uganda. Whenever I pick up a newspaper or I listen to the news, there's always a story about parents asking, what's happening? What are these core skills which our children are being introduced to? Okay, so everyone wants to know. Now, the first thing that I want to say is that I will start by telling you what core skills are not. Core skills are not a new thing, and I will qualify that statement in a bit. The second thing I want to say is that core skills or 21st century skills do not replace the curriculum or the knowledge. They are an addition to it. Okay, so let me explain that. Why did I say core skills are new? Are not new, rather. Okay? When children are young, they're very curious. Okay, I have two amazing daughters, so I know how curious they are. And it can be a little annoying as a parent, because they come with a lot of questions. They want to know what that is. Why is it that way? And they'll keep asking these questions. Okay? It's only when children get to school that's when they stop asking questions, because our education system as it stands trains them not to ask questions. Okay, they are given knowledge which they are supposed to absorb without really interrogating it. Core skills ask students to engage with the knowledge they are being given. That's what core skills are. So they're not replacing what the teachers already teach them. They are enhancing the interaction between the learner and the teacher. Okay, let me give you an example. The pen that you're holding. In a typical classroom, the question that would be asked about the pen is, what is the color of the pen?
Yes.
Okay, and the answer is yellow. So our traditional education system, as it stands now, asks the what question. What is the color of the pen? And the knowledge that the child learns, the student learns, is the pen is yellow. Core skills asks the learner to ask, why is the pen yellow? How does the color yellow come about? Okay.
Is it the best color for a pen?
Is it the best color for a pen? What if I wanted it to be a different color?
Right.
What can I use to change the color? You know, the sort of the questions that interrogate a subject matter. And these are what we call critical thinking and problem-solving skills. So these are not new skills. These are skills that people are born with, okay, that they start with. These are the ones that we're trying to emphasize. We're not saying, when we talk about 21st century skills, we're not saying students should stop knowing what the color of the pen is. we want them to go beyond that and understand how is yellow produced, which colors can you mix to produce yellow. So it deepens the understanding and it brings about knowledge for life, because now when the learner goes outside of the classroom and they want to make a new color, okay, they'll know that the color is yellow. They don't have to look for a yellow color in order for them to paint something. If they've got blue and they've got, or rather if they've got green and they've got red, they can mix the two colors and come up with yellow because they've understood the thinking behind the yellow color.
Okay. Is this supposed to change their thinking? Will it in a way change anything about the learners?
It will, because it opens their mind to new possibilities.
Right.
Okay. With the current knowledge-based type of learning, it restricts the learner in what they can know. In what they can do.
Right.
Like I said, children are very curious. Learners are very curious. They want to know.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, 21st century skills lead to what we call student-centered learning.
Mm.
Because it's the student themselves that are interacting with the matter. And it's not just critical skills. See, from one lesson, instead of just coming away with what type of knowledge, if I can stick to the example of the color of the pen.
Yeah.
Instead of just coming out with the color of the pen, because they've asked that question, they're also developing communication skills. Because they're talking to the teacher, they're asking these questions. Okay.
So we are looking at the learner acquainting themselves with these skills.
Yes.
But how about the teacher? Are there other skills for the teacher as well?
Yes.
You or see, are they intertwined?
They are intertwined because it's coming from both sides. As a parent, I've been asked questions before by my children, which I don't know. My child comes to me and says, why does the sun rise in the morning? I don't know. So I quickly get on my phone and Google, why does the sun rise in the morning? So it's the same for the teacher. When the student asks the question, it prompts the teacher to think about the subject. So the teacher is also benefiting. The teacher is also learning. This is a collaboration process between the learner and the teacher.
Right.
And that's what makes 21st century skills so critical. And this is why we're emphasizing
Absolutely.
Them.
Absolutely. Very, very fantastic.
Just one question. Please, person.
I just wanted to say that the 21st skills century says a teacher has to be more vigilant than they have been. Because first of all, we need both soft and core skills. The soft give you the documents.
Uh-huh.
What is your highest level, PhD, master's degree? But
The core
are very critical. There is nobody who is going to employ a host person like you who cannot communicate,
mm-hmm.
who is not creative.
Mm-hmm.
They give you two questions, you come with them and we answer two questions.
And your
time
done.
Is not off and we are done. And
I feel
and
like I'm having an interview right now.
You see?
I'm being interviewed.
Now, if the teacher doesn't develop those skills in you, then you have a problem with the labor market. That's why you find somebody telling you, I have a degree in business administration. For the last 6 years, I'm looking for a job and I'm not doing, I'm at home. What are you doing at home? That means you can't even develop.
I want you, Ms. Mujisha, to hold it there. Let's first hear from Jillian here. Jillian is the program's director at Luigi Giussani Institute of Education. Now, Jillian,
yes.
The institute is known for its dedication to fostering the development of life of what we have called 21st century skills,
yes.
especially critical thinking among learners in Ugandan schools.
Yes.
Why are you passionate about this? I mean, this is over the years we've learned that we all need core skills, like she has put it. We all need those. People call them the other, you know, skills. The other skills. Why is it so important? Why should we incorporate it, first of all, in our new curriculum? Second, in our day-to-day lives?
Thank you. First of all, I'll speak about Luigi Giussani Institute of Higher Education as an institute of higher learning and then as a development partner. We are lucky that we have two departments. We have a department that trains teachers. And then we have another department under the programs that go to the community, go to the schools, and liaise with the nation. That's why I'm here with Madame Annette, to make sure that learning takes place. So we are passionate that we need to see change in society, and in order to see change in the society, we need to start with the schools, we need to go to the community, we need to make sure we work with government so that we cause this change in the society. So as an institute of higher learning, we offer courses, we offer diploma courses, we offer degree courses, starting with early childhood and care. So we are glad that we have to see a teacher being formed from our institute and then follow up on what the teacher does. And then we have to follow the teachers that have already started their career in the field and then work with them, collaborate with them so that this change is caused in the learners, in the community, with the parents themselves. We also work with the parents so that we see that change happens. So we are passionate about these skills because we need to see self-directed learning taking place. We need to see problem solvers. We need to see creative people in the community. A good example of recent, when we had COVID, we could see that people were asking, where are the biologists? Where are the chemistry teachers who were giving us all those concepts? Because we need a vaccine and the vaccine is not coming. So we have partnered with the NCDC. We are using the curriculum. We go and consult with them. We are using the curriculum for enhancing the skills. You talked about critical thinking. We are very passionate about critical thinking because it can drive life. It can foster it. It can, when you enhance it in a learner, the learner becomes this child, becomes this citizen, becomes this politician who will make informed decisions and who will lead others into making informed decisions. So what we do with the teachers, we learn with them, they learn with us, they learn with the learner. We collaborate. We do not go there to tell them what to do. We discover with them what to do. We have been lucky that we have the resources to study these skills in depth, which is not seen at the school level, because the teachers are at a disadvantage that they look at these skills as abstract things. Yeah. So we go to them and make sure we show them that these are not abstract things. We can deconstruct them and work together and make sure that this learner you have in front of you, this child that a parent entrusts in your care, goes home with some skills, can solve problems, can relate with others. We need skills in our lives. We need them in every aspect of life. We need the cognitive skills. We need the affective skills, as Madame Annette was saying. We need to manage our emotions. If we are working with colleagues, if I'm speaking with my colleagues, I need to know that I need to manage my emotions when I come in, when Madame Annette says this, how do I respond?
Oh, I didn't know that was a skill needed.
It is needed because we live with people, we work with people. So
right.
If you're angry at your job, are you going to perform the way you're supposed to perform? What are you going to do? And you need the skills, you need critical thinking, because you have to ponder the consequences of what you're doing. You have to strategize and know, from this level, where am I heading? What will I do next? So that's why LGI, Luigi Giussani Institute of Higher Education, is very passionate. We have very many projects at our institute that interface with very many people.
Is it that you focus on skills development, or it's a holistic approach?
It's a holistic approach. We focus on very many things, but the skills will help you to maneuver all the other aspects, and then will help us to see how we can enhance them in the school system, in the education system. We don't only go to the schools, we even go to the community, as I've said. For example, we have a project that is working with unemployed youth. We had a study where we found out that the employers are complaining children or students or youth come from universities. They come from these big institutions, but they cannot retain a job. So what is happening? So that is why Luigi Giussani, we keep discovering, we keep learning to make sure that we guide the youth, we enhance, we foster, so that when a person leaves an institute, for example, our institute, can he be able to retain this job? Can she be able to deliver? Can she be able to support the children? We talk about education. Can she be able to support the children so that later in life we have citizens who are problem solvers, who are creative, and who can manage their lives?
Right. Okay.
Can I talk about the program?
That one will come later, just a bit. I want to come back to Ms. Mujisha Annette here. This is the fourth symposium. I want to understand, what do these dialogues help achieve? For example, you had one, the first one, the second, the third, and here is the fourth. Have people come to you and said, by the way, well done with that? And how does that make you feel? Do you see that going a step further?
Thank you very much. I think I want first of all to quote our president. Many people say, you know, this UPE children are very many in class and they don't learn anything. And he says, for any child to leave home and go to class, he will never go back home the same. And I want to say the same with the symposium. Like I've told you, at the beginning of the preparation, we usually call for, we have a symposium theme, and the theme has sub-themes, and all the teachers, the staff in the teacher training institutions are given an opportunity to develop papers to present from their experience. And here is where we give an opportunity to share classroom experience or study experience, because we, by the nature of our state, most of our staff are always on study. They either have to upgrade or study what is failing effective learning in the class. Now, when they submit the abstracts, we have a committee that usually looks at the abstracts, approves or disapproves. Now, when anyone sits down and writes an abstract, whether he's taken on to come and present at national level or not, he cannot be the same as the one who didn't pick any pen to do something. Because by the time you have an abstract, that means you have looked at certain challenge in the class or certain achievement, because I've told you that we share achievements and challenges. Now, the other thing is that every symposium we have a new pattern that comes in. And it is like my colleagues have talked about critical skills. One of them is collaboration.
Yeah.
In everything that we do in life, if you are somebody who cannot collaborate, then you know that you always have a gap within you, in your social capital. Mm. So, first of all, I want to say that we as the department, Teacher Education Training and Development, we have added on our social capital. The people that we had, development partner that we had in 2018, and was the one, we have increased so much. We are now in banks. You know, people say, how do you go in banks? First of all our institutions use the banks to bank the money.
That's true.
All our staff get their salary from the banks. Mm. And the banks come out to teach people how to save, to teach people how to use their little money, to teach people how to make business. All that is an achievement on the side of the teachers. Now, we have been presenting involving people from within the country and from outside the country. Every time you bring somebody from out, there's a lot you learn. Even the people who are inside, there's a lot.
Is this transferred on to the learners as well?
Yes. Now, even when you go around here, you'll find that we have students who can ably present what they have produced. I request you that when you go back, you look at the station where they have students from Guru Christ the King, PTC and Kitugumu. They have developed technological tools that you can use, but when they are developed from the local materials, they have developed a system that can help your child to learn literacy and numeracy, but using the local materials. When you look at it, you'll just see that this is a TV, this is a radio, this is a phone, and they will operate it for you.
Wow.
Now, what other learning would you want?
Absolutely. Okay, before we can take a break, I want to ask Miss, I need to get this name in my head, Shilufia. Mr. Shilufia,
yes.
We have a new curriculum on board.
Yes.
And most critics keep saying, not critics entirely, everybody seems to think this is the best shot we have right now at our education system. What do you think we are doing better now than before, comparing the two curriculums? Because apparently this is the best we have so far right now.
I think what we're doing better, like I had explained in my earlier remarks, is the enhancement of the knowledge that is there. Okay, it's not really changing. We're developing on what's worked before. Okay, and let's be fair to the existing curriculum. It has worked. It's why you and I are seated here, because we went through that. But research has also shown that in today's world, you need more than what you and I got when we were at school. Okay, for example, what COVID taught us, what we all learned from COVID, was that digital skills were very important. And that's something that 21st century skills teach you. Digital literacy is one of the things that we learn. Okay, another thing that it brings out is what we call citizenship. It's about being globally aware. What's happening around the world? Okay, again, going back to the example of COVID, COVID started in Wuhan, China, and quickly spread all across the globe. That calls for awareness. How does it spread across the globe? How do we tackle this together? Okay, so those are the skills that that this new curriculum tries to bring out in the student. Using the same subject matter, but tackling it from a different angle to bring out these other skills. So the subject matter will look the same, but how the teacher brings it out and how the student interacts with it is what's changing. And that's why we think it's a great enhancement, and that's why we think it's going to really help transform the education system in Uganda.
Wonderful, wonderful. We're going to take a break. When we return, I want to speak to Gillian here. Gillian, with the new lower secondary curriculum with us as teacher education and teacher training, how are you preparing training our teachers to implement it? That is a question I want you to, you know, ponder on, and also you, Ms. Mujisha. But we need to take a break. When we return, we're still talking the 21st century skills. You and I need these skills, of course, and they're the most important skills at the moment. There are very many skills we actually learned over during the COVID period. I didn't even know we needed those, but yeah, we are learning. So we'll be right back.